So my kids, they often bring me a toy that they've broken. And the first thing I say to them is, okay, let's have a look at it and see if we can't work out how to fix it. And essentially, structural biology is the same. We're trying to look at the inner workings of the cell to find out how to repair it when things go wrong.
Knowledge of molecular structure is fundamental for developing new therapeutics and vaccines against cancer, neurodegeneration, emerging infections, and many other diseases. And the best way to study those structures is now cryo-EM.
Cryo-EM is a transformative technology that allows us to see tiny molecules at atomic level that were impossible to visualize before.
Most of the work behind cellular function is done by molecular machines made of proteins. And structural biology and cryo-EM allows us to see these machines in enough detail so that we can start understanding how they function and to start designing drugs to target specific aspects of their functions.
My lab studies a cancer-causing protein called BRAF.
Most of my lab focuses specifically on viruses.
It's mutated in a number of cancers, but perhaps most commonly in malignant melanoma.
So for example, we study Eastern equine encephalitis virus, or triple E, which has been making the news recently because of an uptick in the number of cases in New England and neighboring states.
So my lab studies how cells make proteins and protein complexes and how they detect mistakes that occur along these processes.
So my lab is very interested to understand how gram-negative bacteria develop their unique cell wall.
My lab studies a group of rare genetic diseases known as ciliopathies.
And trying to use this knowledge to develop new antibiotics.
Symptoms of ciliopathies include blindness, respiratory disease, and infertility.
So my lab studies circadian clocks.
My lab studies protein molecules in the immune system.
And we're interested in how clocks are built, what they're made of, and how they drive 24-hour rhythms in cells and in whole organisms like us.
So using cryo-EM, we're able to solve structures such as the pore structure that I'm holding here right now. This pore structure allows us to understand how the signal that induces inflammation is released to the outside of the cell.
We're quite confident that understanding deeply how this circadian clock functions will give us a lot of practical information of importance to medicine.
Because of the increased power of cryo-EM, we can begin to understand in a very detailed way now how the BRAF molecule works.
Obtaining this type of information is critical to developing new drugs against infectious diseases and cancer.
Cryo-EM demands huge resources, both financial and technical. And to make it possible, Harvard has teamed up with the Dana-Farber Children's Hospital and the Mass General to build a cryo-EM center that's staffed with extraordinarily talented experts.
Cryo-EM has already transformed structural biology and general biology research, and also will have a far-reaching impact in drug discovery.
What really excites me about cryo-EM is that as a structural biologist, it's changed the way in which I can think about problems.
It completely transformed how we understand biology and how we treat human diseases.
It's a new way of thinking, and it's terribly exciting.